Tonight is a huge night on Raw. There are a lot of things going on. Here in a few moments, I will have a match with Aleister Black. Now, Aleister seems to be a bit, shall we say, confused about things in regards to Rey Mysterio. And he has left me no choice but to enlighten him myself. Now, as for Rey Mysterio, Rey will be on this program later tonight to speak to all of you. And I know it's going to be very difficult for Rey, but my gut tells me that he's not going to be able to bring himself to formally announce his own retirement. And that's understandable, so I have taken it upon myself to handle that formality for Rey Mysterio myself. Now look, if you know Rey Mysterio as well as I know Rey Mysterio, he's too humble, he's too modest to come out to this ring and to call himself a legend. So it is my duty as a leader to come out here and appreciate Rey Mysterio, appreciate the fact that Rey was chosen as a sacrifice for the greater good of Monday Night Raw. Now look, let's stop for a moment. Let's let that sink in. This is a moment that will live in time forever. Rey Mysterio was chosen as a sacrifice for the greater good of Monday Night Raw. If that is not legendary, then I don't know what is. Now, it's true that Rey Mysterio is without a doubt the greatest luchador who has ever lived. Rey has transcended language and border. Rey is undoubtedly a legend, but beyond that, Rey is a kind and generous man. In my darkest hour, Rey presented himself to me. He allowed himself to be sacrificed for the greater good so that I could be the man who stands before you today, prepared to lead Monday Night Raw into the future. And it is my duty to appreciate Rey Mysterio properly. And so to honor the end of Rey Mysterio's career, I have prepared a video package. So let's all take a moment to admire and enjoy the greatness that is Rey Mysterio.
Excuse me, Drew.
Charlie, I've been expecting you.
Well, I am curious. Does the looming threat of Bobby Lashley give you any cause for concern in your upcoming match tonight against MVP?
I think everybody should know by now that I don't back down from any challenge, no matter how dangerous. As a matter of fact, I love challenges. This is week number 9. Since I won the championship, I've faced and defeated 7 superstars. And if MVP wants to get back in there with me, take another claymore, be lucky number 8, that's fine with me. In fact, it'd be even better if Lashley gets in there with me. Imagine that. Boom! Claymore for him too. This is fun. I'm gonna go all the way with this one. If anyone from the locker room, anyone around the ring, anyone off the street wants to step up to Drew McIntyre, I will line each and every one of them up and give them all a one-way ticket to Claymore Country.
Tom, although my eye is still recovering, I'm sorry, man, but I don't have that answer. We still don't even have a timetable on when or if I can return. And right now, honestly, it all depends on how fast I can recover. No, but there's something that really worries me. If an infection were to set in, that could be the end of my career.
Now, Rey, I've known and I've competed against you for several years now. And excuse me for being blunt, but Seth Rollins threw a retirement ceremony earlier tonight for you. Are you here on Raw to retire tonight?
Joe, I really don't know, man. I mean, I don't even know if it's up to me anymore. You know how difficult eye injuries can be. I mean, I can be cleared to compete in a few weeks, or I could never be cleared to compete in the WWE again. It's definitely an answer that we just don't know yet. But it has been a question that I've been thinking about for some time now.
And Ray, this gets back to my point. Considering the severity of the eye injury, I mean, is there anything at all that you would like to address about the retirement ceremony earlier tonight?
As a matter of fact, I do, Joe. You know, for a messiah, Seth clearly carries a lot of negativity with him. And carrying so much negativity can be a true burden for any man. And for Seth to be saying that I was chosen as some sort of sacrifice, come on, Joe. I wasn't chosen by some higher power. Seth made a clear decision to try and blind me and ruin
my... Well, my dad is trying to say is Seth Rollins is no messiah. He's barely even a human being. Appa, something needs to be done about him. Someone from this family. Pero ya. No, how can I chill? He tried to end your career.
I know.
And now he's out there lying about how he was forced to do it to you? That's a bunch of BS, and we both know that.
You're right. Pero tranquilo, mijo. A su debido tiempo. Tom, Joe, I want to take this time to thank everyone for reaching out and for their concerns. That truly means the world to me and to my family. You know, and I know you guys are looking for an official statement on Seth's retirement ceremony. So here it is. Seth Rollins, damn you for everything you put my family through. My wife, Angie, my son, Dominic, and my daughter, Aaliyah, all helplessly watched as you shoved my eye into the steps. They watched blood run down my face. And they saw the man that protects and provides for them suffer. And you go around saying that I cried like a baby when the cold metal met my flesh. Seth, I truly am a man of forgiveness. I really am. But Seth, I will never forgive you for what you've done to me and what you put my family through. Damn you, Seth Rollins. Tranquilo, mi amor. Come on, vámonos. Let's go.
Seth Rollins, you're a man of scripture, an eye for an eye.
Selam güreştürkiye.net severler, lütfen çevirilerimizin devam edebilmesi için kanalımıza abone olmayı ve bildirim ziline tıklayarak bildirimleri etkinleştirmeyi unutmayın. Ayrıca Güreş Türkiye'yi Instagram, Twitter ve Facebook'tan takip edebilirsiniz. İyi seyirler.